Hello everyone, welcome again in Engman YouTube channel. So in this video, we will continue our learning on simple reservoir simulation, simple reservoir modeling, and still about CO2 sequestration. But in today's topic, we will talk about reducing the number of grids in Z-layer. In previous video, we have addressed the issue of reducing the number of grid blocks in X and Y direction. Now we will focus on cutting the number of the number of grid blocks in Z layer. The objective is, of course, to make the model even simpler, such that we can get fast computation. Because if you increase the number of grid blocks, although you will get better accuracy and less error, but of course, it will take more time to compute, to calculate, to complete the simulation. Okay? And just like reducing the number of grid blocks in X and Y direction, this is also going to be quite easy. And let's check definitions. NZ, we have 50 layers. Let's say I'm going to cut it down to maybe 25 or 20. It's quite easy. As usual, let's go into the files here. Okay, let me minimize. Okay. All right, so let's cut it down to, but of course we want to maintain the distance. This one is 50. And the size is 2 here. So 50 times 2, it will be 100. So if we want to cut it down to, let's say, 20. Okay, 20. This should be increased to 5. So that you will get 20 multiplied by 5, you still get 100 feet. This is in field unit, right? Yeah. You still get the thickness, the aquifer thickness of 100 feet. Okay, so that's first. And then, of course, we will check this one. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, we maintain this one. But this one should be 4 to 20. Okay. And 1, 2, 3, this will be 3 grid blocks in vertical direction, or 3 grid blocks in Z direction. Originally, it is 3 multiplied by 2, right? 3 multiplied by 2, so the thickness of the caprock layer should be only 6 feet, 3 multiplied by 2 feet originally. Now we change it to 5 feet per grid block. Okay, so it's going to be, let's maintain it to be 2. Okay, and this one 3 to 20. This one 3 to 20. This one is 1 and 2. And we keep that also for other parameters, 3 to 20. Okay, so we basically say, we basically talk to the model that I want to have two vertical direction of caprock. And for the aquifer, I want to make the aquifer from grid block number 3 to 20 in Z direction. Okay. And maybe we can check it first. Let's see the porosity. So here, this is the original setting. Okay. So if we 1, 2, 3, so the thickness will be from this one, 4 feet. Okay, 4 feet. The size of this one for the size, 2 feet. So from the top of grid block one to the bottom of grid block two, okay, it is 6 feet. But if you measure the center point, it's 4 feet. Okay. All right. And then basically we will change that. I want to have caprock just for the topmost two layers in Z direction. Okay, so I will again take my, okay, so this is our data set and let's change it 3 to 20, 1 to 2. Okay, for the top, only one. Don't forget to save. Also for other parameters, 1 to 2, 3 to 20. Okay. And this one is PVT section. Okay. And then this one. All right, no problem. Okay. So that's it for the main data set. And let's check the completion.